Fine. What did you do last Saturday, last weekend? Were you able to go to somewhere beautiful? I just spent my Saturdays and Sundays at home. Okay, so last time we were able to discuss expressions and equations, right? Do you know the difference between expressions and equations? What is the difference between expressions and equations? Who can still remember?
Me.
Mark, can you still remember the difference between expression and equation?
Yes,
What
it's
is the
simply
difference?
the expression is some kind of math format without equal symbol, while equation has the equal symbol.
Very good. So expression is actually composed of a number and a variable, but it doesn't have an equal sign. While the equation is actually composed of a number, basic operation, as well as a variable, and also an equal sign. So that is the common difference between the two. But if you look at it without the symbol of an equal sign, equation can be expression, right? Okay. Inside the expression, what do you call the letters? What is that inside the expression wherein it is represented by a letter? What do you call that one? Anyone? Can you remember what is the name of the letters being represented in the expression? Who can still remember? Okay. For example, I will give you an expression, x plus 1. What is x? What do you call x? Okay, I will give you choices. Okay, I will give you choices. Is it A, constant? B, coefficient? C, variable? Or D, term?
Herbal.
Variable. Very good. When you see an expression being when you see in an expression being represented by a letters, it is actually called a variable. What about the number? The number without any variable. What do you call that one? What do you call a number without variable beside it? You tell me. Okay, I think I was not able to give you that. But a number inside the expression is what you call constant. Constant. It is not a. It is constant wherein it cannot be a change. So constant is what you call the number in the expression. How about the number beside the variable? What do you call that one? The number beside the variable. For example, 2x. What is 2? What do you call 2? Good evening, Sir Harry. Say good evening to Sir Harry. Everyone?
What is?
Yes, I think the connection is very slow.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
Hello, ma'am.
Hi, sir.
Hello, everybody. Yeah. Okay, let's see.
Good night, sir.
Okay, good, good. How are they doing, ma'am?
I'm fine, sir. We just had a very heavy rain right now, sir.
Okay. So hopefully everybody will be learning something new, okay, today. All right. So are you still waiting, ma'am? Today is only 4 or 5?
better.
Yeah, only 5 students today.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Yeah. Okay. So I'll let you go, Mom.
Six.
Okay. Everybody work hard, okay?
Okay, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Okay, bye-bye.
Yes, sir. Bye, sir.
Bye, sir.
Okay, again.
Bye, sir.
Last time we were able to have, again, I will have to.
Bye-bye, sir.
We have discussed expressions and equations, and we are already in expression. So we already know the difference between expression and equation. So an expression is composed of a number, a variable, and an operation without any equal sign, right? While an equation is composed of a number, a variable, an operation, as well as an equal sign. So okay, I will have to share this one to you so that you will know what I am trying to tell you. Okay, this one. So expressions and equation. So can you see the slide? So an equation.
I can see it.
Okay. So when we are going to define what is an expression and expression, so an expression is a number, a variable, or a combination of numbers and a variables. Some examples of expressions are 7, 4x, 5a plus b, or 3 times quantity 2m plus 1. All of these are examples of expressions. There is no equal sign. So it is composed of numbers. 7 is a number. 4 is a number together with a variable which is represented by a letter. And then a combination of a number with a variable as well as the operation and look at this. This is the same with the third one. Okay, so these are all expressions. Expressions can also be linear expressions. This is a type of expression wherein it is the sum of terms that are either rational numbers or a rational number times a variable with an exponent of either 0 or 1. By the way, when you say rational numbers, it is actually a number with a numerator and a denominator. Take note, a constant number can also be called as rational number. All constant numbers, or I mean all numbers, whole numbers, or any numbers, they have this invisible denominator of 1. If an expression contains a variable, it is called an algebraic expression. If an expression is contains a variable, it is called an algebraic expression. To evaluate an expression, each variable is replaced with a given value. Okay, how about if the expression doesn't contain a variable, it only contains a number? What do you call that one? What do you call a variable wherein it only contains a number, a numerical value? It is called numerical expression. Okay, it is called numerical expression. So if an expression contains a variable, then it is called an expression. Again, a variable can be represented by a letter or a symbol. So if you are going to evaluate an expression, what you are going to do with the variable is you are going to replace or substitute the variable with a given value. For example, x plus 1. I am going to assign a value for x which is equals to 3. So if you are going to replace or substitute the value of x with 3, then it will become 3 plus 1 is equals to 4. Okay? And then rational numbers. Okay, look at this. These are all rational numbers. It can be a whole number, a decimal number, a negative number. What else? These are all numbers. And then a fraction. We all know that a fraction is consist of a numerator and a denominator. So if we are being asked if this number and this fraction are rational, then yes. The only number here that is not rational is the number with a radical sign. This one, the last part, it is not called a rational number. Okay? It is not called a rational number. It doesn't have a fraction actually. Okay? What else? Rational numbers can be easily identified with the help of the following characteristics. All integers, whole numbers, natural numbers, and fractions with integers are called rational numbers. So all integers, whole numbers, natural numbers, and fractions with integers are rational numbers. Okay? What do you call an integer? What do you call an integer? You know what is an integer? What is an integer? Anyone? If I am going to look at it, an integer is a, okay? An integer is a, wait a minute. What is an integer? Can you see this one? Can you see the, can you see what I am, showing right now? An integer is a positive or a negative whole number. A positive number is a plus sign and a negative number is a minus sign. Okay, it is a minus sign. Okay, what else? So an integer is those numbers, I mean an integer is a positive or a negative sign. This is what you call sign. And then if you are going to assign number, I mean an integer with a number, it is also called a rational number. So equivalent expressions are expressions for which a given value can be substituted for each variable and the value of the expressions are the same. I was able to go with this one last time, right? So equivalent expressions are expressions in algebra that are equal in value even though they look different. Equivalent expressions will have the same value when we use the same values for the variables. An algebraic expression is two or more numbers and letters that are combined with mathematical operations such as plus, minus, times, or divide. So these are the four basic mathematical operations. Plus, minus, times, or divide. Okay, so this is the symbol that we use when we talk about equivalent expression. Equivalent expression. So it shows that the left side and the right side expression, they are identical. The only difference would be the placement of the terms. It would be the placement of the terms. So we will talk about integers and terms later on. We will talk about that one, okay? So addition is commutative, which means changing the order of the term does not change the sum. Look at this. Look at the example. 3x plus 7y is the equivalent expression of 7y plus 3x. Look at this. 3x plus 7y is the same as 7y plus 3x because the coefficients of x are the same. By the way, what is the coefficient of 3x and 7y? What is the coefficient from 3x and 7y? Who can answer me?
What?
What? The coefficient. Do you know what is a coefficient?
No.
Coefficient is the number beside the variable. It is the numerical value beside the variable. So 3x, between 3x, 3 is the coefficient and x is the variable. So we have, yeah, so we have two coefficients from the binomial expression. What are those? These are 3 and 7. Look at the left side as well as the right side. The coefficient of x is 3. Same with the variable of x on the right side. It is also 3. The coefficient on the left side of the variable y is 7, same with the variable coefficient of the variable y on the right side, which is also 7. And they are all both positive. By the way, when you cannot see any sign beside the number, it is understood that it is actually a positive sign. When you cannot see a sign beside the number, such as this one, 3x plus 7y, 3x here is actually a positive number, or 3 here is actually a positive number, because we cannot see any other negative sign, right? So, for example, another example is 3a minus 8b is equals to 3a plus quantity negative 8b is the equivalent expression of negative 8b plus 3a. So why is it that they are both equivalent or the same, or they are identical? If you look at it, the negative sign belongs to the term after it, this one. Look at this one. This negative sign actually belongs to this term, okay? If you are going to multiply positive and negative, then it will become negative. So they are different sign. If you are going to multiply different sign, then you will have a negative sign, okay? Subtracting a term is the same as adding a negative term. Subtracting a term is the same as adding a negative term. So you are going to, look at this, you actually subtract a term from the left side, and on the right side, you add another term, but this term, after the sign, after this, after adding it, it is actually a negative sign. So it is just identical with the left side and the right side. Look at this. So they are actually equivalent expression. So these are all expressions, by the way. And then multiplication, it actually has a distributive property which allows us to break up a number into simpler parts and multiply each part separately. This can be used with variables as well. So we will know about variable, we will know about terms, we will know about what else? We will know about coefficient, so that you will be able to remember when you go by and become and be in middle high. Okay, I will have to show you the other one that I was looking at earlier. So I have been trying to make a PowerPoint presentation, but then again, I was not able to do that because was actually I actually got a short time. Let me have this one first so that you will know what I am actually telling you all about integers. So I tried to make one. I only screenshot it. But I will try to look at it again and share it to you, okay? As this one. I will have to share this one to you regarding the features, so that you will know what we are actually talking about. This one. So what is an integer? I was asking you this one earlier. So an integer is actually, okay, a positive or negative whole number including zero. So this is how you make a model of that integer. So if you look at it, this is an example. If I have to make a number line, this also looks like a number line wherein the center one is the zero, part is the positive value. So these are all what you call an integer. So it can be a positive or a negative whole number. Okay? And then there are four integer operations. There are four integer operations. What are the four integer operations? These are addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. Okay? Addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. Look at this. This is addition, the plus sign. Subtraction is the minus sign. The multiplication is the x sign or the times. The division is the divide. Okay? And then, what are the rules for integers? Okay, listen carefully. We are talking about rules for integers. When signs are the same, add the numbers. When signs are the same, add the numbers. Okay, look at this. Negative 5 minus 1 is equals to 5 plus 1. Okay, how did it become like that? Let me try to have this. Okay, so it is as if like this. Negative 5. So we are going to add it according to this one, right? Add. Plus negative 1 is equals to, okay, negative 5. Okay, if you are going to multiply positive and negative, it will give you a negative sign. Okay, if I am going to multiply positive and negative, the plus sign, I am going to multiply the plus sign to the negative sign of the integer, then it will give me a negative sign. And then copy only the positive, I mean the number. So if you look at it, negative 5 and negative 1, do they have the same sign now? Do they have the same sign now? What do you think? They already have the same sign. Therefore, you are going to add 5 and 1. Then copy, okay? Then copy its sign. The sign is negative and it will give us negative 6. Okay? It will give us negative 6. Again, if you see a number having the same signs, okay, they have the same sign, then you are going to add the numbers. You are going to add the numbers and then copy the sign of the number. So in this case, negative 5 and negative 1, they both have negative sign. That is why you need to copy the negative sign and then you add the numbers. 5 plus 1 is equals to 6, and that would give us negative 6. Okay, do you have some questions? I have been talking since earlier, but I think some of you still confused with this lesson. Can I ask if you have some questions regarding this? Anyone? Do you have some questions with which you think you cannot understand?
No.
No? Is it okay if we continue or we need to go back? What do you think? What would you like us to do? Would you like us to go back or give you more examples so that you will be able to follow? Anyone? Can you understand me? I know that you can understand me, right? Do not be shy. It is just us. And we are trying to, we are trying to help you learn the basics regarding these sign numbers. Okay? Do I need to continue now or do I need to go back? What do you think? Anyone? No Nobody will answer. Can I ask somebody to answer for me?
Give you more examples.
More examples. Okay. Look at this. So we will have more examples, right?
Yes.
About the same sign, you are talking about the same sign, or you are talking about continuing and introduce the signs, and then give later on I will give you more examples. What do you think? Huh? Okay, how about this one? Let me shut this. Let me try. Okay. Three plus one. What is your answer? Three plus one. Anyone? Nobody knows.
Four.
Four. The answer is four. Okay. Let me tell you this one. You can you see any sign beside before the three? Can you see a sign before the number three?
Yes.
What is the sign before the number three? Can you see a sign before the number three? This three. This is the one that I am talking about. Can you see any sign beside this one? Before this one? What do you think? Noel, can you see a sign beside the number three? Noel?
Yes.
What is the sign beside the number three?
Plus.
Before the number, not after the number. Before the number, not after the number. Can you see a sign before the number?
No.
No.
Okay, if that is the case, this three here is actually understood as a positive number. This three here is actually understood as a positive number. Okay? Sometimes we do not use the positive sign when we write numbers with which we know is actually a positive number. But if it is actually a negative number, we need to write this sign before the number. Look at this, the negative sign. The negative sign is usually placed before the number. So this one is actually a negative number. But this three here is actually a positive number. So again, a positive number is actually a number with which we seldom uses the positive sign. Okay? We seldom uses the positive sign because it is already understood that this number is actually a positive number. While a negative number, we need to write the negative number. Okay, do you know how we are going to place that one in a number line? Okay, I will try to make a number line. Oh, what kind of number line is that? Wait. How can I make? Let me have a line. Okay, this one. This would be our number line, okay? The center for this one is actually our zero. So this, the center here would actually be zero. On the left side, all the numbers on the left side are actually negative numbers. So these are actually negative numbers. While on the right side, these numbers on the right side are all, okay, look at this. These are all positive numbers. Okay? These are all positive numbers. So if you look at this, 3 is actually here. So the positive numbers, we do not or we seldom use the positive sign. But in the negative number, which is actually here on the left side, we use it all the time to identify that that number is actually a negative number. Okay. How about this one? This one, these numbers here. What is this? Is it positive or negative? What is this number here? 5. Is it a positive 5 or a negative 5?
Positive 5.
Positive 5. Very good. So in this case, look at this. They added negative 5 and negative 1, right? Because they have the same sign. And look at the sign. The sign of the largest number is 5, right? The sign of the larger number is 5, so is the sign of 1. Therefore, they copied the sign and make the answer as negative 6. How about this one on the right side? 5 plus 1 is equals to what? 5 plus 1 is equals to what? What is your answer? 5 plus 1. What is your answer? 5 plus 1. Is 5 positive and 1 is also positive?
6.
Yes. So what is your answer? They are both positive. So you are going to add it. What will be your answer?
6.
6. Okay. What will be the sign? Is it positive or negative?
Should be negative.
Huh? What will be
positive.
The sign?
Positive.
What?
Positive.
Positive. Very good. So if you look at this, it will not, 5 plus 1 will give us positive and not negative answer. Because we will always copy the sign. Okay? We will always copy the sign. In this case, they are both negative number. We add it all and then we copy the sign. We copy the sign of all the numbers. If, and then we will talk about the different signs. Let me erase this one first. Let me erase this one. Okay. Next. Oops, sorry. Okay, this one. When listen carefully. When signs are the different, or when signs are different, subtract the numbers. Again, when signs are different, subtract the numbers. Look at this. Negative 5 plus 1. Negative 5 plus 1 is equals to, just distribute this one, 5 minus 1, but they will have different answers. Okay, negative plus 1 is what? They have different sign. What will be your answer? Negative 5 plus 1 is what? They have different sign. Are you going to add it or are you going to subtract it?
Subtract.
Subtract. So how about the sign? What will happen to the sign? What will happen to the sign? What are you going to you going to do with the sign? Are you going to what? What sign are you going to use? So negative 5 plus 1 is, according to Inda, you need to subtract. So what will be your answer? Shitya. What will be your answer, Shitya?
What is?
Negative 5 plus 1 is what? What is your answer? According to Inda, if we have an integer having different sign, then we are going to, okay? We are going to subtract. So what will be your answer? You are going to subtract. What will be your answer? Negative 5 plus 1. Inda, what will be your answer, Inda?
Five.
Subtract 1 from 5. What will be your answer?
4.
4. How about the sign? What will be our sign now? What will be the sign of our sum?
Positive.
Is it positive? Okay. So listen carefully in the end sheet. Yeah. So what number what sign has the biggest number? sign has the biggest number? Is it the 5? I mean, is it the negative or the positive? What sign has the biggest number? Is it the positive or the negative? Negative. So we are going to copy the sign of the bigger number. So the answer is 4. Then we will adopt negative. Negative 4 will be your answer. Look at this. So we are going to use the negative sign because according to this expression, we can see that, okay, we can see that the 5 or the negative has the number, the biggest or the largest number, which is actually a negative value. Therefore, 4, we have the sum of, or the difference of 4, then we will adopt the negative sign, which is negative 4. The answer will be negative 4. Okay? How about this one? 5 minus 1. 5 minus 1. 5 is positive and 1 is negative. 5 is positive and 1 is negative. What will be your answer? According to the 4, what will be the sign?
Positive.
Very good. So you are slowly getting it. So if you can see, like on the left side, this is an expression wherein it is composed of negative 5 plus 1. Okay? Negative has the largest number. And then if you look at the expression, they have different sign. Then we are going to subtract it. And then we are going to copy the sign of the largest number or the bigger number. So on the right side, we have this 5 minus 1. Earlier, I told you if you cannot see any sign beside or before the number, then it is understood that it is actually a positive number. So positive number and a negative number, they have different signs. Then what we are going to do is we are going to subtract. And then if you look at the expression, the positive sign has the bigger number. Therefore, we are going to copy the sign of the bigger number, and that sign is actually a positive sign. So the answer would be positive 4 or 4. Okay? And then what? Next is, okay, this one. Okay. Let me ask you about this one. I need to ask you. Okay? I forgot. Okay. I am actually trying to wait. It was already highlighted, so you will know already, right? We will know already about this one. So it is already highlighted. Okay, look at this. If you look at this on the right side, these are all our answers. Okay, this is what I am actually telling you all about. This is actually the answer for number 1, number 2, number 3, number 4, and number 5. So how did it become negative 1? Okay, look at the equation for number 1. How did it become negative 1? What can you see about the expression or the equation? What is 5? Is it positive or negative? What is 5? Is it positive or negative? For number 1, I am talking about number 1. What is 5? Is it positive or negative? You want? This one. I am talking about this 5 here.
Positive.
Positive. So according to the rule earlier, if you add a different number or if you can see two different signs, then what are we going to do? We are going to subtract, right? We are going to subtract. So if you look at it, I am going to subtract it, then the answer will be 1. The question will be, what sign are we going to adopt? Look at the sign of each number inside the equation. Look at the sign of each number in the equation. Which sign actually has the bigger number? Is it the positive sign or the negative sign? Which sign has a bigger number? Is it the positive sign, which is 5, or the negative 6?
Negative 6.
negative 6. That is why, if you look at it, we adopt the sign of the negative sign. And the answer would be negative 1. Okay? That is why our answer is negative 1. Same with this one for number 2. Negative 3 plus 2. Negative 3 plus 2. They have different signs, right? A positive or a negative and a positive. According to the rule, if you have two different signs, then we are going to subtract. I am going to subtract, then I will have to add, I am going to write 1. And then I will have to go back and look at the sign. The sign of the negative, as the number beside the negative value is actually bigger than the number for the positive value. That is why I am going to use the negative sign. And the answer is also negative 1. Okay. 6 plus 5. Both of them are positive. So they have the same sign. They have the same sign. So according to the rule, if you can see an expression or an equation having used the same sign, then what we are going to do is that we are going to add it. We are going to add it. And then if you look at the sign, they are all positive. So when I added 6 and 5, it would give me 11. And then when I look at it, they have this positive sign. That is why I adopted the positive sign. I may opt to write a positive sign, or I may not have to write the positive sign because it is already understood that it is actually a positive number because it doesn't have a negative sign before the number. And then the next one is negative 8 plus 7. Okay, look at this. They have different sign. The negative sign has the bigger number. That is why we need to adopt the negative sign. And we are going to subtract. And that would also give us negative 1. On the other side, which is the number 5, positive 9 minus 9. So they have different number. Therefore, I am going to subtract it. And that would give me an answer which is equal to 0. Okay? The answer would be equal to 0. Okay? Okay. You have some questions? So again, remember, if signs are the same, okay, you need to remember this one. If signs are the same, add the numbers. If signs are different, subtract the numbers. Then give the answer the sign of the largest number. So we need to copy the sign of the bigger number when we are going to subtract the numbers, okay? What are the rules for integers? Okay, look at this. When parentheses are involved, we get to doodle. When parentheses are involved, we get to doodle. This is where you need to draw some faces, okay? But you didn't know you'd be doing art in math. So we are going to use parentheses. Look at this. We are going to use parentheses. So what are the rules for adding and subtracting integers? So look at this. When you multiply a positive and a negative number, you are going to get a negative number. When you multiply a negative and a negative number, you are going to get a positive number. And then when you multiply a positive and a positive, you get a positive number or a positive sign. What are the examples? 5 plus negative 1. Okay? 5 plus negative 1. Okay, look at this. Plus, we are going to multiply it to the negative 1. Take note, when we use a parenthesis, we are actually trying to divide. When we use a positive, we are actually divide. We are actually going to multiply. I'm sorry. We are actually going to multiply. This is what was actually being said earlier, that when we use a parenthesis, then we can make faces. This is what they are actually telling us. Okay, look at this. a positive and a negative number. When we see these kinds of expression or equation, then what we are going to do is that we are going to multiply. So positive times negative would give us a negative sign. That is why if you look at it, 5 minus 1, 5 is a positive number and 1 is a negative number. We are going to subtract it and it will give us 4. Because 5 is actually a positive number. And then another one, when you multiply a negative and a negative number, you get a positive number or a positive sign. 5 minus quantity negative 1, okay? Negative times negative will give us positive. Look at this, negative times negative will give us positive. So 5 plus 1 is equals to what? 5, take note, 5 is a positive number, so is 1, then it would give us 6. Because when we are going to have a number having the same sign, then we are going to add the numbers. And then look at this. When you multiply a positive and a positive a sign, you get a positive sign also. 5 plus quantity positive 5 is equals to 10. Why? Positive times positive would give us positive. Okay? Positive times positive would give us positive. That is why we can see that they have the same sign now. Then we are going to add 5 plus 5 would give us 10. 5 plus 5 would give us 10. Okay, how about this that? I will not use the examples because they already have the answers. How about this one? I am going to give you an example. Okay. Three plus negative one, what will be our answer? They have different sign because if you look at it, positive times negative will give us negative sign. So what will be your answer? Anyone? What will be your answer? Look at this. 3 plus quantity negative 1. We are going to look at the sign. Then we are going to multiply the sign from the sign outside to the sign inside the parentheses. So positive times negative would give us negative. Then what will be our answer? Huh? What is it in the?
Two.
What will be your sign in the? What sign are you going to use? Positive or negative? What sign has the number, a bigger number? Is it the 3 or the 1?
The 3.
3. So the answer would be positive 2. 2. Very good in that. How about this one? Negative 10. Okay. Plus. Negative 10 plus 5. Okay, look at this. Look at the sign. Again, look at the sign. Positive, the sign outside, we are going to multiply it from the sign inside the parentheses. Although we cannot see any sign inside the parentheses, it is understood that it is actually a positive number. So positive times positive would give us positive number. Okay? It would give us positive number. Then what will happen? What will happen to this one? Are we going to add it or are we going to subtract it? Take note. Okay? Take note. We have now different signs. We have different signs. Are we going to add or are we going to subtract?
Subtract.
Subtract. So what will be our answer?
Minus 5. Negative 5.
Negative 5. Because 10, negative, actually as a bigger number. That is why we need to adopt the sign of a bigger number, then subtract the number. So 10 minus 5 would give us 5. Wow! Okay, very good. Next is... okay, look at that. 13 minus positive 7. Again, look at the sign. If you see a parenthesis, after the sign, then you need to multiply the sign to the numbers inside the parenthesis. So this 7 here is understood as a positive number. So negative times positive would give us negative. So 13 here is what? A positive number or a negative number? What is 13? Is it a positive number or a negative number? Can you see a sign beside or before the number 13? Can you see a sign before the number 13? Do we have a sign before the number 13 here, Alfonso? Do we have a sign before the number 13?
13 minus 7.
Yeah, what will be the sign for the number 13?
Is it positive?
Positive. Very good. So a positive and number, they have different sign. What are we going to do? We are going to add or subtract?
Subtract.
So 13 minus 7 is?
6.
6. Is it positive or negative?
Still positive.
Still positive. So I can write it as 6 only, or I can also use positive 6. Okay?
Okay.
Okay. So always remember, if you multiply a negative and a negative number, or a positive and a positive number, that would give us a positive sign. But if you multiply a positive and a negative sign, then it would give us a negative sign. Okay? Again, how about Teacher Samira, if I am going to multiply a negative and a positive? Like that. Then it will also give us a negative sign. Okay? Negative times positive would give us negative. Positive and negative would also give us negative. Negative and negative would give us positive. And positive and positive would also give us positive. So, in short, when you multiply different signs, it will give us negative sign. If you multiply same sign, then it will give us positive sign. Okay? It will give us positive sign. Let me erase this one first. Then we are going to continue. Next. Okay, practice numbers wherein these are all the answers, right? Negative and negative would give us positive. That is why we added 4 and 5, and it gives us 9. And then positive and negative would give us negative. Then we subtracted 7 from 9, and it would give us 2. A positive 2, to be exact, because 9 is actually a positive number. When we added or subtracted a negative, when we subtracted a positive and a negative number, a positive and a positive number, take note, okay, take note. The answer here is wrong. Look at this. Unless otherwise, it is 12, okay? So negative and positive will be negative, okay? So since 6 is positive and 2 is negative, then we are going to subtract, then copy the sign of 6, which is positive. So it should give us positive 4. Then 8 minus negative 7 is actually, I'm going to multiply the two negative signs, negative and negative, would give me positive sign. So it will become 8 plus 7 would give us 15. All of them are all positive. That is why the answer for 15 is also positive. 9 plus positive 3, they both have the same sign. Therefore, positive times positive would give us positive sign. And then, according to the rule, if we have, if we are going to see a same sign, then we are going to add it. Therefore, 9 plus 3 would give us 12. Okay? 9 plus 3 would give us 4. So, according to this, we need to remember to draw the faces first. If signs are the same, add the numbers. If signs are different, subtract the numbers. Then give the answer the sign of the largest number. Okay, so if you are going to make faces, even though it is a positive number, you need to write the positive sign so that you can draw faces. You can see here the eyes, and then the mouth. The eyes, and the mouth. Right? Eyes, and mouth. So it is actually, it looks like a circle with mouth and eyes. Next, we still have 1 more minute. Okay, so continuation of the practice. This one. So I think you know that one already. Okay? And then it is about multiplying integers. So the product of 2 integers with the same sign is positive. We all know that one. The product of 2 integers with different signs is negative. Rule summary for multiplication. Positive times positive is equals to positive. Negative times negative is equals to positive. Positive times negative is negative. Negative times positive is negative. This one. So positive and negative, positive 6 and negative 3 multiplied together, positive and negative will give us negative 18. Positive and positive, positive 3 times positive 3 is positive 9. Negative and positive, negative 4 times positive 5 would give us negative 20. Negative and negative would give us negative 6 times negative 2 would give us. And negative 7 times 8, both of them are negative. Then this is why we will be able to arrive to a positive 56. Okay, so we will continue that one tomorrow. We will continue that one tomorrow. I will try to make some problem wherein you will have to answer it. I will make sure that the problems that I am going to make will have no answer when I am going to share it to you. Okay? Okay, so I think it is